Simuelue Basin. The Simuelue Basin, figure 3, is a moderate-sized, 100 x 260 km, basin with sediments of up to 5 s two-way travel time off Sumatra Island, for example. The basement of this basin is considered as the continental backstop of the Sumatran continental crust with a regional horst and graben structures which might be generated from the late Eocene to early Oligocene, figure 3a. The northern part of this basin, figure 3a, shows depositional and deformational styles changed between units 3 and 4. A contractional strain ascribed to landward vergent thrusts in the retro wedge was recorded before the deposition of unit 4. On the other hand, the strata of units 4 and 5 are characterized by seaward tilting and seaward migration of the depocenter, suggesting the seaward side of the basin subsided relative to the landward side during that time. A. Northern part of the Simuelue Basin. B. Central part of the Simuelue Basin. C. Mentawai Basin. D. Western Java Basin. E. Lombok Basin along the Java Trench. Locations of the survey lines are shown in Figure 2. The depositional history of the central part, Figure 3b, was divided into four stages. At the end of Paleogene time, ca. 40 Ma, a regional erosional surface was developed after slope sediments covered the topographic lows, Unit 1 in Figure 3b. An early/mid-Miocene stage is marked by a rapid subsidence in the trenchward and thick deposition occurred along the seaward margin of the basin, Unit 2. During the late Miocene/Pliocene, subsidence continued in the northern and the trenchward region of the Simuelue Basin, Unit 3. The basin from Pleistocene to recent was under an influence of strike-slip faults due to the oblique subduction evidenced by a wrench faulting, and subsidence expanded significantly landward, Unit 4. Mentawai Basin. Deposition and deformation of the Mentawai Basin have been strongly influenced by imbricated seaward vergent four thrusts in the accretionary wedge and landward vergent back thrusts in the Mentawai fault zone, figure 3c. This fault zone has both characters of strike-slip fault, for example, and back thrust. The fault zone may have initiated during early Middle Miocene and indicates the arc parallel transpressional features along the boundary between the accretionary wedge and the continental backstop. A continuous contraction developed the full thrust belt during Pliocene time. The oldest deposits in this basin are the Middle Oligocene-Early Miocene, which thinly cover the Forearc slope, Unit 1 in Figure 3c. Since the latest Early Miocene, uplift of the outer arc high began with imbricated four thrusts in the accretionary wedge, which reduced the thickness of Forearc basin sediments trenchward to the outer arc high, Units 2 to 4. At the same time, landward vergent back thrusts also developed near the boundary between the accretionary wedge and the continental backstop. Although the activity of these thrusts waned in the early late Miocene, Unit 3, it reactivated in the late late Miocene, Units 4 and 5. This intense deformation might be induced by accretion of thick Bengal fin sediments and increase of plate convergence rate since the late Miocene.